It's me, Stormie, and here's your horoscope for October 2018. And Virgo, this month, man, we got to watch these plans. We're going to have to really get into, re-look over, reconsider the value of the plans that we've got going on, because the idea, Virgo, this month is to get through the mental minutiae, get through the mental BS to the truth, and I'll tell you all about that. But first, let me tell you that there is the opportunity for you to pick up an appointment with the 2018 holiday gift. It is in the description box down below. You can click that, or you can come book at stormygrace.com. Right now, appointments are only left for December and January. So if you'd like to grab one and we can talk about any of the good stuff going on for you, jump in there and let me know. Okay, Virgo, first of all, the big ticket item for this month is that Venus is going to be going retrograde, and she's going retrograde in the sign of Scorpio. So whenever we're having a Venus retrograde, which hopefully you checked out my video on Venus retrograde. If you haven't, check it out in the playlist, okay? Whenever we're having a Venus retrograde or any kind of retrograde, it sends us backwards. We're going back. We're going introspective. We're looking to the past on things. And yes, Venus retrograde is absolutely infamous for bringing back past lovers or people we had maybe even considered having relationships with and we never went for it. They could be coming back. Now, they could be coming back in all sorts of different ways. You could just, you know, be thinking about them, or you have a dream about them, or a passing thought about them, but it turns into something bigger so that you can look at it and maybe do some healing from it. It could also turn into, you know, that person actually shows up or something like that. So whatever it is, that doesn't necessarily mean that's what's going to happen for you, but it does mean that Venus, being our planet of love and romance and sensuality and yes and pleasure, she could be bringing some romance back into your life. Now, Venus is also a planet of finances, of money, right? Of value. And value here is not just money. It's also self-esteem, how you value you, how you value your talents that you're putting out there. So all of these things have the opportunity to not only come back to the table, but you will be re-looking over them and reconsidering them, okay? Now, Venus retrograde in Scorpio. Scorpio is an intense, let's get to the bottom of this, let's go to hell and back kind of energy, right? It wants the truth of what's going on. Scorpio is intuitive, is masterfully intuitive, and is not just going to trust anybody, right? So where this is so phenomenal for you is that this retrograde is actually happening in your third house. First of all, I think that this is just gorgeous for you, because in the third house, which is the house of our, it's our first mental house, our thinking, our patterns, details, strategy, of course, writing, communication in any form, learning, studying, absorbing information. We've got siblings and neighbors, buying and selling things. All of those are down here, that website. Yes, please. Okay. It's all down in this third house. But with the energy being here, where I see this as an absolute benefit to you is that it is going to help you relook at some of the people in your social circle, and not necessarily your social circle like, hey, these are my close friends, but in a work capacity, in a school capacity, in a get yourself out there kind of way, who are you running with? What connections do you need to make to take yourself to that next level? Do you need help getting that website launched out? Do you need peace and forgiveness between you and your siblings, right? That could definitely be something that's coming to the table, because Venus does want to bring harmony. And here she's going to bring harmony to the past, but she's going to do it by digging up the truth. She's going to use that Scorpio energy to dig up the truth. So I'm telling you, with such an intuitive energy that you're working with, trust your gut, okay? One of the other things I keep thinking about with this Venus retrograde in Scorpio in the third house for you is that there may be conversations. You're maybe having to have conversations or do counseling or seek medical attention or something like that. And it's about digging through the truth of something sexual for you, whether it be sexual trauma, your current sex life. Scorpio's over reproductive things, so maybe you're having conversations in that direction as well, or maybe it's on your brain, you know, you're getting to rethink your thinking here. Whatever it is, this Venus retrograde is very, very good for going back, having conversations that need to happen to launch you forward. Maybe you're starting school. That would also be a wonderful way to be using your Venus retrograde time, okay? Now let's jump in and see what else is going on this month, because that Scorpio energy is busy, but there's a full month we need to take care of, okay? So at the beginning of the month here on the 5th, we've got that Venus going retrograde there in Scorpio. I told you about all of that good stuff. And don't be afraid, Virgo, this month. If you need to take some time, if you need some private time to back up, back out, think about what's going on, think about maybe these new people that you want to connect with, and maybe they're not new people in your networking zone, but maybe there are people connected to a project you did. Did you communicate something out and now these people are kind of pouring in and they're talking to you about things of value? They're giving you opportunities to make money. There may be an opportunity that was available before becomes available again. You know, Venus is just trying to bring it back into you. And if you need some quiet time to reevaluate if that's what's right for your life, is this relationship with your sibling right with your life? Take your time. Scorpio is a private energy. You have 6 weeks to brood on it, honey. Let yourself breathe and trust your gut, okay? On the 8th here, we've got a new moon happening in Libra. This is going to bring some new life to your second house, okay? Now, first of all, the new moon is where we plant these seeds of intention of what we would like to happen going forward, right? The sun and the moon are here in a conjunction, and when these two are conjunct, anything's possible. Anything's possible. So likely what's been happening is, during September, you've had some truths come to the surface. You've had some new projects come to the surface. You've done some healing, some mending, especially around work and definitely your love life. And now you've got this new moon here that is a place of value, right? It's value. Your self-esteem could be different, the way you value yourself. This is also a wonderful, wonderful energy for bringing an opportunity to make more money or to take a talent that you have out in the world and have it have value and have it returned in a financial way. I also think that because this is a moon in Libra, Libra wants to seek balance. She wants those scales balanced, right? So you're looking for equilibrium. Where in your life, Virgo, is it too much work and not enough play? Where is it too much? Maybe you're with people, but they don't really know that you value them. Where are you not feeling valued in your world? Where do you feel like you could take this up a notch? Where is that balance for you? Where's the equilibrium for you? So I think this will be an interesting month to see what you do with that, but it is certainly a beautiful brand new start. It could bring new partnerships into your value world as well. I just told you could be networking, so we could be making some cool partnerships, maybe mentors even coming into your life. All right, on the 10th, now Mercury is going to enter into Scorpio. So we've got Jupiter up there, we've got Venus up there, now we've got Mercury up there. So Scorpio is a busy house, I'm telling you. The third house, which Mercury is very comfortable in the third house, he typically rules that house anyway. Mercury in Scorpio doesn't make you necessarily it doesn't make you as polite all of the time as you would like to be, but you will be having conversations that have value. They're rational. You're looking at things from every angle. You're making decisions that are very savvy. They're very intuitive. Trust yourself. Trust that quiet voice inside of you that's speaking, because Mercury, as he starts talking here, he's looking for the truth. He's looking for the truth. He's looking for value here, right? He's looking to make plans. He's looking to adjust your strategy and help you. He's helping you. Mercury is forward. He's not retrograde yet. So this is also an energy where you yourself are going to be speaking the truth this month. And I am telling you, you may be speaking with a little bit more passion, a little bit more fire. Maybe you're having to speak up around some things that maybe you weren't speaking up to before. Now, I will say too, just with all this Scorpio energy happening and really on fire for you, please be mindful of manipulative people that are in your world or doing or saying things that are manipulative to try and get your way. So make sure you don't step into that zone, okay? All right, on the 23rd, now we have the sun joining this Scorpio energy. So see where the sun goes. It's light, heat, life, and vitality. You want to be seen. You want to be heard. You want to be known here. So you're going to be doing things to get this third house together. Now, first of all, Scorpio energy with the sun in there means you're trying to transform. So I'm telling you, you're looking and searching and digging and pulling and speaking the truth this month. You're changing your mind. You're getting a different perspective. You're studying. You're adding value to your mental things. You're adding value to information that you have. And that is going to change the game, because it's going to change you by the end of the month. And it's not going to change you in this whole find yourself, be authentic. Okay, like whatever, do that on your own time. What's going to happen is you actually get information you need to move forward, or you share information because you want to transform this area with the sun there. Now, on the 24th, we've got the full moon coming into Taurus, a fellow earth sign. First question here, where do you need to reground? Where do you need to just take your shoes off, get into nature, feel your body, feel your hips stacked, feel everything in alignment, grounded, right? Lift your shoulders, lift your heart. Where does that need to happen for you? Now, Taurus lights up your ninth house, and the full moon says that something has to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. So we are going to create a shift here. Now, the ninth house, publishing, broadcasting, getting yourself out there in some way, shape, or form. It's also about studying, schooling, licensing, certifications, foreign things, foreign travel, foreign people in our lives, speaking a foreign language, religion, faith. This is ultimately a space of faith. So with the full moon happening here, this could definitely be a thing where you're ending a project, you're ending a broadcast, you're ending some schooling, something like that. You're ending a teaching job, you're ending being in one country, and now you're going to start being in another country, or someone in your life is doing that. But the other thing that this makes me think of is that you could be having a shift to your public, what is my word? Your public personification. The way that the world has been seeing you, you might be a lot more public. Maybe you've done something to broadcast yourself. Maybe you've put yourself out there. Maybe you've put a book out there. You're speaking to something, but either way, you're getting bigger here. This energy is going to help you to expand, but it has to end you in one version in order to bring you out in another. So you see that shift has to happen. Now, if this has to do with schooling or education or something, it's showing you what adjustments need to be made, or it's bringing them to a close over this next 4 weeks. Again, this expansion out though has so much to do, Virgo, with things of value and finance and money, that I think that this actually has a really nice tie into that. Now, on the 26th, we've got Venus and the Sun in conjunction, so holding hands together up there in Scorpio. This tells me you're going to have a shift or a change to your social life, so welcome these people in. And it doesn't mean everybody's coming to stay forever. It really doesn't. But it does mean, ooh, okay, that full moon too, you could be having yourself broadcast differently, a different faith, a different experience or something like that, and it might not be entirely long-lived. It will probably last you for the next 6 years. Something about it lasts for about the next 6 years. Okay, anyway, shift to the social circle on the 26th, okay? Now, on the 31st, we've got two movements. First of all, we have got Mercury moving out of Scorpio and moving into Sagittarius. This is phenomenal for making you really open-minded. This is phenomenal for giving you strong, optimistic, very self-confident conversation, making decisions. This is going to be running through your fourth house, so you could be making some decisions around your house or your home. Do you want to move? Do you need to change something in your house? You know, are you going through your budget? I definitely think that Mercury in the fourth house says, do we have money for this, right? But this could also be a place of clarity. What information did you gather, did you share, did you put together that's led you to a brand new conversation in this fourth house? Home, real estate, family, property, grounding, foundation, information from the past. What information did you get that will help you make decisions here in this fourth house as of the 31st? Also on the 31st, we've got Venus taking her retrograde on the road. So she's going to move from the sign of Scorpio back up into the sign of Libra. So now, again, lighting up the second house, you're looking at value. How are you going to make money, right? Virgo, are you thinking you need to take this career and stay at home? Is there a shift? Did you get a new job opportunity? What's going to add value to your relationships? This is a relationship energy in Libra. Maybe you're having to look back over that. Do the people around you know that you love them, that you care for them, right? Where's the value? But also Venus being retrograde in your second house. Now, please take a look at that budget. Please take a look at your finances. Please take a look at how you're going to do money and value going forward, okay? I think it's going to be a pretty good month. I would have absolutely no doubt that September was a little bit heavy, but also had moments of epiphany, I would hope for you. And in October, I think it's to be a nice transition reset kind of month for you as we get ready for the end of the year. So keep me posted on what's happening for you in the comment section down below, okay? Like this video, comment, share, subscribe. Feel free to let me know what you think about the background and the new camera. And I will see you guys in the next video. I love you guys. Bye.